Commonplace and different, intimate and distant, fresher than an infant.
Black, my family thick like that strap molasses. Star on the rise in the eyes of the masses. Black is the color of my true love's hair. Stars are bright, shining, hot balls of air. Black
like my Spike Lee.
Spike Lee.
Favorite Spike Lee movie? White Man Can't Jump.
Brooklyn, I love that movie growing up. That's why I'm so excited to see him come for the state of race here at Emory University.
Spike is from my hometown, Brooklyn.
I also love School Days. I love, what are some of his other movies? I love all of his movies pretty much, but Brooklyn is most definitely my favorite.
And he's guaranteed to say something that I'm going to want to hear about firsthand.
All right, my name is Ben. I'm a senior in business school. And my opinion on the NBA lockout is that it's millionaires arguing with billionaires, but I can actually understand where it comes from on the side of the owners. All right, most people don't know this, but most NBA franchises are actually losing money, so the owners need to do something different for in order to make money, because nobody wants to do a business if it's not making money. So in that sense, I actually side with the owners more than the players. So yeah, that's my feelings on the NBA lockout.
I personally think that the fans are affected the most because, like, we watch it and, like, there's nothing else to watch, really. I like NBA a lot, so it kind of sucks that, for selfish reasons, I think, that they're having this lockout to get more money, pretty much, when, like, we should be thinking about other people because they're probably already rich regardless, so... And I guess, like, the other thing that's affecting is, like, the new players, I guess. Like, the old ones aren't really affected because... They already, like, established their place on the team. They already make a lot of money. But, like, the new ones that just got on the NBA and, like, are drafted, they're kind of stuck because that was their future career and they now have nothing to do. So
I just found out Kim Kardashian's not married anymore, and that's a shame. I think real love is worth fighting for longer than however long they were married for.
My name's Vanetta Thomas. I'm a graduating senior at Emory University, and I'm going to talk about Kardashian, failed love or scam. I just think she's looking for love in all the wrong places. She just wants to be married. Failed love, I guess.
I'm JoJo. I am a freshman in Long Street. And where did BET go wrong in regards to programming? Why don't people watch it anymore? They don't have enough to balance out a lot of the ratchetness, to be completely honest. You know, a lot of that stuff, it's funny, it's cool, but where are the shows like The Cosby Show? Like, there were shows like A Different World, like all these types of black shows that really did represent black people, sometimes in negative lights, but also in positive lights. There was a lot of balance. And now there's just not. And I think a lot of people are getting discouraged now. A lot of people feel embarrassed. And even if it is a matter of, you know, internalized oppression, I think there still needs to be something that represents a lot of the more positive qualities of black people and like black families. They're trying to make a comeback with that show with like Tracee Ellis Ross and like Homeboy from The Cosby Show. I have yet to watch it. Hopefully it's good, Cosby-esque. So I think they're trying to make strides into a better direction, but we'll see what happens.
My name is Trezor Carr. I'm a freshman, class of 2015. And freshman year was, well, first semester of freshman year, definitely harder than I thought it was gonna be. I thought it was gonna be a breeze. I thought I was gonna take easy classes, and I thought I was gonna do really well. And I've had to drop like 3 classes. I'm currently in the process of withdrawing from one of them. And it was actually nothing that I thought it would be. I got caught up in a whole bunch of stuff I should have never gotten caught up in, and now I'm just trying to kind of back and reevaluate my life and where I want to go, and my mentality on things and stuff like that. So freshman year, first semester is, it's a word I can't say. It's definitely an illusion, actually. It's definitely not what you think it is. So yeah.
How are you gonna improve on it second semester?
Well, first and foremost, I'm gonna make sure that I put my academics before social at all times. I'm not gonna go out and party when I know I have a paper to write. And I think that's pretty much it. Making sure that I prioritize correctly. So that's what I'm gonna do.
Against the canvas of the night appears a curious celestial phenomenon. Unless all get down.